Now, already this week, we've told you about the rising issue of self-harm among young people. It's led to calls for greater mental health provision.
Now, a rugby league player is hoping he might be able to persuade young men to talk about their feelings to avoid more turning to suicide.
Luke Ambler's been campaigning since his brother-in-law took his own life last year. Luke set up Andy's Man Club, which runs sessions every Monday in Hull for men to share their problems.
Well, now he's enlisted the help of Fixers, the campaign that gives young people a voice to urge families and sons to get in touch with their emotions.
I got a phone call. It was my mother-in-law, Elaine, and she just told me our Andrew's dead. Then I'd obviously heard that he'd taken his own life, which just completely shocked me. There weren't no signs, no signals, no warnings. And it just leaves constant questions of why? And them questions will live with us forever, really. My name is Luke Ambler and I'm from Halifax. My Fixers project is to try and cut suicide rates in young men by getting them to talk about their emotions. Just under a year ago, my brother-in-law, Andrew, took his life. I wouldn't say Andrew was the type of guy that would talk about his emotions. I'd put him in a category of probably 90% of other guys, really, or 99% of other guys, really. It's quite a rare thing to find guys who are willing and openly open to talking about their emotions. I truly believe if Andrew would have spoken to anyone about what he was going through or what he was thinking, he'd still be with us today. The statistics around male suicide are shocking.
Suicide is the biggest killer of young men aged between 20 to 34. Young men in that age category are 3 times more likely to die by suicide than females. 42% of men in that category are likely to have thought about suicide. And why is that? Men don't do emotion.
We've made a short film to get my message across. Today I'm showing it to members of Calderdale College's rugby team.
Hey now, come on, stop that. Don't cry. Don't be a girl, be a man. Come on, men don't cry.
He's a man talking to his son and telling him to man up. And then when he starts to get older and he wants to start expressing his emotions and he's crying, he feels like a cat because it's not manly to cry. And he wants to be a man and then he feels like it's too much because he really has got no way to be able to express that. And then it resets the video and shows actually a different way of the dad talking to the son by actually encouraging him that it's okay to be upset, it's okay to talk.
You're allowed to be upset, you know. It's okay to cry.
So how important do you think it is, lads, to talk about your emotions?
I think it's really important, Luke. I think, you know, over time, if you don't talk about your emotions, they all build up. And that on top of, you know, dealing with everyday life, it becomes a struggle.
Depression can be really a really dark and lonely place. And once you do start that conversation with someone else about your own feelings and your mental health, you can really start to get better.
It's very important to open up about your feelings. I mean, just keeping them bottled up, just like I say, it sends your mental inside and eats away at you.
You know, we don't want other families to go through this and we don't want other guys to go through what Andrew's going through. Because at the end of the day, thoughts create emotions, don't they? And that's what we're doing. So if we can use the language to change the thoughts and the thoughts to change the emotions, it's job done.